Temperature plays a critical role in orchid growth, their blooming cycles, and their overall health. So how much variation in temperatures can orchids handle successfully? There's an ongoing debate amongst orchid growers whether orchids should be grown in their native habitat's original temperature ranges, or whether over time orchids can be adapted to grow and flower well in temperatures that they wouldn't usually. So before I get the cold shoulder on this one, welcome to the Nature Company. Today we're looking at the great temperature debate and what variations orchids can handle. That brings us to episode 9 of our hotly debated orchid care topics. So let's have a look at those different viewpoints and some of the science around them to help us understand it better. And at the end, we'll go through some different temperature ranges and what orchids these ranges are going to suit the best. If this is the kind of information you're interested in, please hit that subscribe button down below if you haven't already, and that notification bell to be notified of all our upcoming content so you don't miss out on a thing. So with this debate, it generally centers around 3 different viewpoints. Firstly, cold growing orchids will not tolerate the heat. Secondly, orchids will adapt to different temperature conditions if given enough time. And thirdly, all orchids need variable temperatures to actually grow properly. Let's have a look at these 3 different viewpoints and see if we can implement any of these into our own growing strategies to ensure great success. So firstly, it's those cool growing orchids that just won't take the heat. Is this true or not? Orchids like Cymbidiums, Masdevallias, Miltoniopsis are considered cool growing orchids. These generally come from high altitude areas where the temperatures never really reach higher than around 25 degrees during the day. And at nighttime, they get a big drop in temperatures. So they're generally growing in relatively cool climates compared to some of our other orchids. And why do these cool temperatures matter to these orchids? Well, for one, they're flowering. A lot of them need a cool period to actually help force the flowering, whether it's extended periods of really cool temperatures or whether it's really big fluctuations in those day-night temperatures to help force those flower buds. And without these periods, you may just get a lot of lush top growth and no flowering at all. Also, with these orchids having adapted to these temperature ranges, heat stress can be a big problem. This will not only cause dehydration and possible scorching of the leaves, but also cause failure to absorb nutrients properly. Also, they need these cooler temperatures to make them less susceptible to pests and disease. Because as those temperatures rise, it weakens the plants and they become more susceptible to fungal infections and insect attacks like spider mites. And scientific studies have shown that Cymbidiums need at least a 10 degree Celsius, which is about 18 degrees Fahrenheit, drop in temperatures between your day and night temperatures to actually help initiate that flower spike. If they don't get these sorts of variations in day-night temperatures, you'll get lush growth, but probably very little to no flowering at all. So what are the challenges facing people wanting to grow cool growing orchids in warm climates? Well, there's going to be a need for artificial cooling. So you're going to be needing to run air conditioners or have evaporative coolers or something, and this can actually be quite expensive to run to ensure that you have the correct temperatures for your orchids. Also, in warmer areas, often your humidity levels can actually be quite low, and this can then cause desiccation of your plants. So you're going to have to find a way to increase your humidity levels so you don't have drying of your plants, as the hot, dry air will make it difficult for these cool growing orchids to thrive. And I'm afraid even if you're getting your orchid to survive in these warmer areas, these cool growing orchids will often produce very sparse or even deformed flowers. So you're not going to get a proper flowering out of these cool growing orchids in warm climates if you're not able to produce the temperature ranges that they require. So if you're living in these warmer conditions, what is best? Well, if you particularly like these cool growing orchids, rather look for some of those hybrids that are coming out where they've been hybridized to be able to live in warmer conditions. There are many growers now working on hybrids of these cool growing orchids for those warmer climates. interbreeding them with warmer growing species, or even going into generic hybrids to try and bring in some of that warm tolerance to them. And now viewpoint two, orchids can adapt to warmer growing conditions. Even those cool growing orchids can slowly adapt over time to warmer conditions. As many orchid growers say, a lot of orchids have successfully been grown well outside their natural range. Cymbidiums, for example, have been grown in subtropical and even tropical environments for many years now, after a long period of slow acclimatization. So they say by gradually acclimatizing your plants over many seasons will toughen them up and allow them to grow successfully and even bloom. And hybridization is a big part of this. Growers have been hybridizing these cool growing orchids for many years now with more warm tolerant orchids to allow for a broader range of temperatures in which they can be grown. And these new hybrids are often a lot more tolerant of a bigger variety of temperatures than what their wild relatives are. And also the science has proven that there are orchids that are able to adapt their metabolic rate to suit the temperatures that they are growing in. But of course, this is very species specific, and not all orchids are able to do this, because a lot of those cool growing orchids are only adaptable to a point, because excessive heat will still cause protein denaturation and cell collapse. So what are the methods we can use to help grow these cool growing orchids in warmer climates? Well, it's all going to be related to trying to keep the orchid cool. So it's all got to do with providing enough shade for it, so you're not giving it direct light, so we're not getting that buildup of heat inside the leaves themselves from that direct sun. Also, we'll be looking at any cooling that you can provide, like evaporative cooling or misting, or by placing it near a large water source, a pond or something, where naturally your temperatures are going to be slightly lower. Also, by providing extra humidity. This will help reduce the dehydration stress of the plant. That's always going to be helpful in those hotter, drier conditions. And then of course, improved airflow. This is going to be extremely important to help keep coolness around the leaves, so that as the air is blowing over the leaves, it's help keeping the leaf itself in a cooler state, and in such preventing heat stress. So what's going to be the best practice here? Well, adaptation is not going to be foolproof. Some of those orchids just won't adapt properly to your warmer temperatures. So rather choose hybrids that you know are going to be heat tolerant and that will manage in those conditions that you have available for them. This is going to provide you with a lot more success than trying to force sensitive plants to adapt. That just might not. And viewpoint three, temperature variability is important for all orchids, no matter whether they cool growing, warm growing, or intermediate. They all need that fluctuation in temperatures, be it seasonal or diurnal, your day-night temperature ranges. So these fluctuations matter because many orchids, even those warm growing orchids like Phalaenopsis, need that day-night temperature drop to be able to flower properly. And Phalaenopsis, generally you're looking at between a 5 and 10 degrees Celsius difference in your day and night temperatures to help it bloom, which is around 9 to 18 degrees Fahrenheit. And this is what is going to help force that flower. And with a lot of other orchids, such as your dendrobiums, they need a cool spell in winter. So an extended cold period with which will help them force the flowering. This is a seasonal change in temperature that's going to help produce that flowering. And often it's a cool, dry period that they need. Also, by providing that little bit of stress for the plant, it's helping reduce the chances of weak, leggy growth, as constantly warm temperatures will often produce excessive vegetative growth, being weak and leggy and with often very few flowers or a very weak flowering. And scientific studies have shown that orchids like Phalaenopsis and Cattleyas store energy differently due to temperature fluctuations. And with constantly warm temperatures, you can delay flowering as you don't get specific seasonal cues from changes in temperature that would naturally happen. And this may delay your flowering. So that even goes to show, even warm climate growers growing warm climate orchids need to at least get diurnal changes in temperature, temperature fluctuations to help manage your plant's seasonal changes. And this will ensure the best flowering. So let's have a look at some of those different temperature ranges and some of the orchids that are going to be specifically suited to grow best in those situations. First, there'll be cool growing orchids. These are daytime temperatures of between 15 and 25 degrees and nighttime temperatures between 5 and 15 degrees. This is 59 to 77 degrees Fahrenheit for day and 41 to 59 Fahrenheit for the evening. And orchids that are going to suit this the best are orchids like your Cymbidiums, your Masdevallias, your Miltoniopsis. They will particularly like these temperature ranges. And most of them need a cooling period to flower properly. And then we have the intermediate orchids. These are temperatures from around 18 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees during the day and around 12 degrees to 15 degrees during the night. And then we have your intermediate orchids. These are orchids that prefer daytime temperatures between 18 and 27 degrees Celsius and the evening temperatures between 12 and 18 degrees Celsius. In Fahrenheit, that's 64 to 81 degrees Fahrenheit and 54 to 64 degrees Fahrenheit in the evenings. Often these orchids are able to tolerate higher temperatures if you're providing them with higher humidities. And these are orchids like your Oncidiums, your Paphiopedilums, and of course your Zygopetalums. Now for those warm growing or hot growing orchids. These prefer daytime temperatures from around 25 degrees Celsius to 35 degrees Celsius, and the evening temperatures anything from around 18 degrees Celsius to around 24 degrees Celsius. In Fahrenheit, that being 77 to 95 degrees Fahrenheit and 64 to 75 degrees Fahrenheit for the evenings. And these orchids benefit from that constant warmth and of course those slight drop in nighttime temperatures to get the best blooming. So what's the final verdict on, are orchids able to adapt to non-native temperature ranges? Let's have a look at that first argument. Cool growing orchids should be kept cool growing. Well, for one, the pro in this is you're going to get better growth and better flowering out of your orchids. The con is that to keep those cooler temperatures can be quite difficult in warmer climates. And the best way to go about it is by growing in shade houses with extensive cooling systems to ensure that you are able to get the temperatures needed for them. And the second argument, orchids can adapt to the different temperature environments that you have. And the pro is, yes, some of those orchids are able to adapt. But the con is, even those that have adapted, if there is excessive heat, they are still going to be damaged by those heat stresses that will come, even if it is for short periods. And the best way of going about it is actually look for those hybrids that are more heat tolerant and grow those instead. And of course, the third argument, temperature variations are key for all orchids. And indeed, this is what is going to give you the strongest, healthiest growth out of your orchids. But the con here is that not everyone is able to control the temperatures for all of their different orchids. So you may land up having to choose ones that are going to be suited to your climate. And the best way of going about it is allowing for seasonal and day-night temperature changes for your orchids to ensure that you can get the best out of them. And the final tip, choose plants that are going to be particularly suited to your climate. Choose ones that are either heat tolerant or are hybridized with more heat tolerant orchids, so you have a better chance of getting an excellent result out of them. So if you're living in a warm climate, choose Vandas, Phalaenopsis, Dendrobiums even, those warm tolerant ones. And if you're living in a cool climate, choose things like Cymbidiums, Miltoniopsis, Masdevallias. And that way you're not fighting nature. If you have found any clever ways overcoming the temperature requirements of your orchids, please drop them in the comments box below. We'd all love to hear about them. And if you're still confused about some of this information, please have a check in that Buy Me a Coffee link down below. Ed posts a lot of orchid related content down there all the time, available to everyone. There is also members only content, so don't be shy. Sign up, become a member, and grow like a pro. And thank you for watching. If you found any of this information helpful, please hit that like button, hit that subscribe button down below, and that notification bell, bing bong, to be notified of all our upcoming content so you don't miss out on a thing. Help us grow as we help your orchids grow.